This video is a little different as we're going to look at something that features everywhere inside the control panel, but holds a special function that separates it from the rest of its brothers. We're going to be looking at the orange wire inside of the panel, why it's special, and what we use it for. Now, you may be asking, how can an orange wire be special? Well, it does not exactly have superpowers, but inside our panel, it holds a secret that we are going to find out. But before all of that, please don't forget to like this video if you find it useful. We want to continue to bring you new and exciting videos to further your learning, and this gives us the motivation to come up with more exciting and easy to follow videos in the future.
Within the panel, we have a number of orange-colored wires. You may wonder what these are for. As we've already heard of the blue and white wires connected to the PLC. Well, what these wires are for is to give power to devices when the main switch or panel isolator is in the off position. Why would we want to keep things on when we've turned the power off? I hear you ask. Isn't that dangerous? Well, to put it simply, no. If we try to understand the different colored wires in a panel, this will help us to understand why those that are colored orange are suitable to work even when the main switch is off. The colors of wires and panels are required by law to follow the Machine Safety Standard EN60204 Part 1. This is so that there is consistency and for safety. In power circuits, AC and DC, we have this color coding. AC phase will be black. AC neutral will be light blue. Positive DC will be black. And earth will be green-yellow. In control circuits, AC and DC, we have this color coding. AC live will be red. AC neutral via transformer will be red. AC neutral mains will be light blue, and positive DC will be blue. Interlocks and circuits supplied from remote panels will be orange. In this case, not the one we're after. Finally, earth will be green-yellow. Panel services are 240-volt AC supplies for panel internal lighting, programming console socket outlet, internal heating and cooling, CPUs for memory backup purposes, etc. These are accepted circuits, as defined in EN60204 Part 1, and as such are not disconnected by the main panel isolator, but by a separate isolator mounted inside the panel, and designated maintained supply. The color coding for multi-core cables is like this. The sheath will be orange. AC live cores will be orange. AC neutral cores will be orange. And earth cores will be green-yellow. The color coding for single core cables is like this. AC live will be orange. AC neutral will be light blue. And earth will be green-yellow. So, we come back to the original question. What wires in our panel are orange? Well, firstly, we have the panel internal light. We want to be able to see when we turn the main switch off. Next, we have the socket. This will allow us to keep our laptop charged up. If the panel needs to be turned off for an extended period of time, then when we're ready to go, our laptop may have died. Not good. The socket is protected by a fuse so that any spikes in power won't damage our laptop. The final thing we have in this panel with power is a topic we've already covered, the thermostat and cooling fan. As we've already determined, we need to be able to keep the panel cool, even when the main switch is off. So how does this all work? Well, inside the panel, we have the mains feed three-phase power that comes into the panel to a set of terminals labeled L1, L2, L3, and N. You can see from this that one phase, L1 and N, has orange wires in it. It is separate from the other wires in this terminal block, so that they act independently. On the back of the main switch on the left-hand door, the wires are identified as L1, L2, L3, and N, matching what we have on the terminals. The outgoing side of this main switch will be isolated if the switch is off, and will be powered if the switch is on. The main switch is connected to the contactor labeled 150K1. When the switch is on, giving power to the panel, this contactor will be pulled in, or energized. Once this is energized, power can be distributed around the rest of the panel.
That was intense. Hopefully you've now learned the orange wire secrets. It's important to remember this one. It could save your life. Now that you've learned the shocking truth behind the orange wire, what's next? Stay tuned to find out. Again, this video was brought to you by RealParse in partnership with ProControl here in the Netherlands. They are experts at control system design and industrial automation, and they have a team of world-class automation engineers and have been designing and implementing industrial control systems in different industries for many years. If you want to get in contact with them, you can check out their website at pro-control.nl. That's pro-control.nl. We'll pull the link to their website in the description below the video as well. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you have learned something new from this video, it would mean the world to us to like this video. If you have not already subscribed to the channel, please do so. When you subscribe, don't forget to hit the little bell next to the subscribe button to be notified each time that we post a new video. If you've got any thoughts or questions, add them in the comments below. We read each and every comments and reply to it in less than a day. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.
Want to learn PLC programming in an easy-to-understand format and take your career to the next level? Head on over to realparse.com.